In my last example, I used the standard normal table to find cumulative area or probabilities for given z-scores. Now I want to show you how to get the same answers using the TI-84. So my first example from my previous video was finding the probability that z is less than 0.70. To do that on the TI-84, you want to go to your distribution menu, which is the same place you went to when you were working with the binomial distribution. Select option 2, or scroll down to option 2, the normal CDF, which stands for normal cumulative density function. Now, you need to note that it expects a lower bound and an upper bound. That's why sketching the area or the probability being asked for is especially helpful. So when you're asked to find the probability z is less than 0.70, the area technically would start, or theoretically would start, from negative infinity. The calculator defaults to this number. It's negative 1 times 10 to the 99th power, which is an extremely small number. If your calculator didn't default to that, all you would need to do is put in a negative 1 with a bunch of zeros after it. So in other words, you want a very small number here to indicate negative infinity. So my upper value, or my upper bound, is going to be 0.70, and it defaults to standard normal. See how mu is 0, sigma is 1. We don't want to change those when we're working with standard normal. And then press enter. If you have an older calculator and you have to input everything on your home screen, you want your lower bound first, your upper bound, mu, and then sigma. If mu and sigma are 0 and 1, you could close the parentheses and it tells the calculator that you are working with standard normal if you close the parentheses right after the z-score. Otherwise, you can just input 0, 1, and that would be consistent when we're working with a non-standard normal case. All right, and then pressing enter, we'll get this area of 0.7580. The table rounds to 4 decimal places, so this is consistent with what we got when I did this in my previous example. My next z-score that I wanted to find the area for was the area or the probability to the left of z equals 1.67. So again, that area is that z-score is above 0. I expect that area to be greater than 0.5. Going back to my distribution menu, selecting option 2. Again, my lower bound is going to be an extremely small number, so I'll leave that alone. My upper bound in this case, when I'm working with a z-score of 1.67, will be 1.67. Leaving mu and sigma alone, because the mean is 0, standard deviation is 1 for the z distribution. And then you see it copies that information to your home screen. Lower bound, upper bound, mu, sigma. Press enter. And that area or probability to the left of 1.67 is 0.9525. Sorry, that was tricky to say for some reason. And again, we expected that area to be greater than 0.5 because we were above 0. If we had a z-score of exactly 0, that cumulative area to the left would be exactly 0.5. The next z-score I'm interested in is negative 2.83. So I want to find the cumulative area to the left of negative 2.83. Going back to my distribution menu, going back to normal CDF, since I'm working with less than, I can leave my lower bound alone. My upper bound will be negative 2.83. And then down arrowing past everything else. And then enter again. Very small area because we are literally almost 3 standard deviations below the mean. Okay, so a z-score of -2.83 means we are 2.83 standard deviations below the mean on the standard normal for the net standard normal distribution. So that area to the left of it is going to be very, very small. Last but not least, let's find the area or the probability to the left of a z-score of -0.18. So again, selecting my distribution menu, option 2. If I want the area to the left of -0.18, my lower bound will be of an extremely small number. I'll just show you, I could put in a -1 and a bunch of zeros. Okay, that's for all intents and purposes, that's close enough to negative infinity. All right, so my upper bound would be -0.18 if my z-score is -0.18 and I want to find the area to the left of that. Scrolling past mu and sigma and then enter and then enter again. We'll get an area or a cumulative area to the left of -0.18 of 0.4286, rounding to 4 decimal places. I expected that area to be less than 0.5 because my z-score was below 0.